It is so much cooler here tonight. It's beautiful and rainy and much easier to sleep. It's also good, like being back after having time off. Like, I can only like work one day, then I need like the day after to like rest and recuperate and recharge. And then, yeah, so on and so forth. So, well, the last 48 hours have been interesting, though. Darren Hayes came to me in a dream. Came to me in the dream state while I was sleeping. He told me that I have my facts wrong, that I'm off point on this, which I don't like being told. He told me that no, what these crooked fucking law enforcement dicks are doing is they're trying to push a lie. And they're trying to fabricate, like falsify evidence too. So I was like, well, what then? He said, 'cause I remember this when this happened a couple of years ago, that fat fuck from Cantermoon's Tarot got one of my clients to take a picture of me naked. But I didn't know about it. Plus, when I was at work, I was always high. Now, Luke was sending around those photos of my tits. Because I found out about it. From one of the bitches that I worked with. So he asked someone to take a picture of me naked to make it look like he took it. Or something to make it look like we were fucking, we were having sex, what have you. And he also broke into my home and stole underwear. And he was even asking, because one of the girls at work showed me this. I kept the group conversation to try and steal items of my clothing. Because at the time I was going through a lot. I was going through a lot then. And at the same time I was also having a struggle with addiction. Using and then trying to come off it, but because of all the trauma and bullshit, I was having a hard time. So, he made up this filthy fucking lie. That he impregnated me and that I miscarried from using drugs or some shit, from not looking after myself, or I aborted it. Some rubbish. I'll have to go back and read it. No, I confronted him on Instagram and he said, I don't know who you are and I don't want to know who you are either. So you're still trying to push that lie by falsifying evidence. Well, I've got my own fucking receipts from that time. When I actually miscarried, I was 4 months pregnant. You cunts assaulted me, which caused a miscarriage. After I went to the clinic myself and got the result, and they said negative. And I scanned it and I put it onto my USB. So, I guess it's back to the drawing board. Darren, I would have preferred if we were having sex instead of talking about these pathetic, dumb cunts. Now, before when I was watching Superman, Scorpio's only Teru came up. So I like him, he's fun to listen to. And he said that all of this BS is happening because these grunks are trying to steal my money. Trying to get me incarcerated by trying to frame me or trying to set me up. Well, so-called set me up. That's not gonna happen. You are going to be giving me you are going to be giving me a payout and a public apology. For having disgusting, dirty, fucking rat bitches sitting outside my fucking apartment on their phone stalking me. So you can come and plant drugs in my fucking apartment. And you're trying to set me up. Oh yeah, and also hacking into my emails and fabricating, making up fake emails. No, you cunts are the ones that are going to be getting incarcerated. Not me. There was also an investigation, I believe, as well, which cost taxpayers dollars. So, yeah. This man. His channel is called Scorpio Only Teru, and he said that investigators, found out that's what you cunts were doing, what you're up to. So, you're trying to incarcerate me to get my money by setting shit up. When I've got, dreams and promises that I want to keep to myself, that I'm keeping for myself. Really? Really? Do you think that you deserve my money after doing all of that? I don't fucking think so. Also, Andrea Smelly Box said that there is a air sign, a Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius female that's also trying to, take me down and take what's mine. Yeah. Very, very underhanded and sneaky. Very underhanded and sneaky. Not to mention that people actually died, from what I've heard. People have actually lost their lives from the lies that Luke was telling people about me. I've never met that fat cunt in my life, nor do I want to. So it's physically impossible for someone that I haven't met in person to impregnate me. But you're trying to push that lie by fabricating, by falsifying evidence. Go ahead. I dare you. I dare you. Oh God, I can hear police sirens going off. For the feds, there was a head left in a cooler at a cabin area. Someone reported the cooler as well as Redmond's exact description. That is sick. I was shaking when I read that. I also heard that some of you were plotting to... Someone was going to send people my way to argue with me to try and make me sick or to stress me out so that I would like die or get sick. You've just heard me yell. And that's not even the loudest that I can yell either. You would not have the balls to come face to face with me. You can sit behind your fake social media profiles or come at me in groups, but that's it. But that is it. Now, the night before, in the dream state, I was in Lulu, House of O'Shawn's house. She could not see me. She did not know that I was there. This is in the dream state. In the dream state. So she could not see me, but I could, like, I was in her house and I was watching her. What she was doing is she was actually fucking around with black magic, all right? So she had, it wasn't a cauldron, it was just like a pot. And she just kept on saying, like, it was to slow down the investigation. Anyway, there was just this thick black smoke that was coming out of this pot, and she was choking and choking and choking and spluttering everywhere, and then eventually she passed out from like the toxic fumes that were coming out of this pot because she's been screwing around with black magic, death magic, what have you. Anyway, not that long ago, Daisy was like, you know, talking about black magic and death magic and things like that. And like Lulu from House of O'Shawn, she actually looks like a clusterfuck. It's probably like from all those like toxic fumes from like these death spells or whatever that she's all this black magic that she's trying to do to slow down the investigation. Now, why people would only be doing that kind of things, like, I was in the same room as her, but it wasn't actually affecting me. It, like, affected her. It made her sick to pass out. And that's why she looks like shit. But it didn't affect me whatsoever. So, like, why would a clusterfuck like that try to, like, why would she be doing spells to slow down an investigation? So she wants an investigation slowed down. It's like, for a reason. Okay, so last year there was an attempted murder at my home in August last year. So it was over a year ago. Now, I was so, like, I wasn't scared. I was just pissed off. And, well, as anyone would be if they had, like, you know, someone coming to their home to murder them. And I wasn't actually a subscriber of Daisy's because she was talking about black magic and things like that. And I didn't believe in magic and shit then. So, okay. So, You know, I have to admit that I am one of those people that if I don't understand something, that I call that person crazy. So that's what I was like with her. So anyway, so this was August last year. She said that, yeah, when her and this other scrag called Ghetto Nun, they were having a fight. And I listened to Ghetto Nun because she's funny. That was like back then. And Daisy said, this was the morning after that attempted murder. She said that people died in a death magic ritual. Or like they did like this death ritual and two people like, you know, got killed. How sad is that? As well as this year, you know, she put on her, talking about Daisy, it was actually good to hear from her finally, even though she had to deliver some really good, fucked up news. I miss her. She put onto her community board a few months ago, like June or July sometime, advising me to find an anti-satanic practitioner because like these people put like an end, like satanic like magic on me using like actual human sacrifices. So people that had been murdered and put into like these death rituals on me, and I was like, what the fuck? Like I couldn't feel anything, but I just felt sick, like to my stomach. I don't know who the fuck this is. Moonwater Taro said, danger, something serious is happening. Okay. This always cracks me up when I read it. I miss you. Their demise is finally setting in. Don't engage with the lepers. You know, I've never like I never heard her go off ever until like that day when I passed out in the shower and I had that huge bruise on my leg. And the next day after, she was like, you only have one more time. You got one more fucking time. Oh my god. And she deleted like this video when she was going off at Gavin Newsom, and she's like, you think the feds are watching me? They're not watching me, bitch, they're watching you. But she took that down. So yeah, like I've I was on the fence for a long time, like, you know, whether I do believe in black magic, death magic, what have you. I actually do now. I am a believer in it, but I don't even want to like mess around with that stuff, you know. Like I haven't watched any ghosts. I've only watched, I think, one episode of Ghost Adventures this entire year, which was like the Cecil Hotel, I think it was. I'm so sorry. I should do some catching up though. You know, and you know that Bobby Mackey's episode, what happened to the caretaker of Bobby Mackey's when he got possessed by something? There was a priest that performed an exorcism, and he sadly passed away not long after that. And they even, if I find the video on YouTube, which I don't think I will, I don't know, like, Ghost Adventures, like, those guys, like, you know, work really hard. You know, they work really hard. So I just don't think it's right for people to be uploading their stuff on YouTube. You know, we actually should have to pay them to watch it. But if I do find this, I'll put it in a link in the description down below. But you know the movie The Exorcist from the 1970s? They interviewed, because that's based on a true story, they interviewed I think it was the great niece of the priest that performed that exorcism, but it was actually a boy. And so what the real story is, like, you know, this boy went to college, messed around with a Ouija board, came whatever the fuck he came in contact with, like, followed him back to his home, and all hell broke loose. I don't know what video. Oh my god, when I screamed before, that really hurt my throat. I don't know what video this was. I don't even remember the date. I just remember that I was watching Sex Education, which is one of my favorite shows. I'm always excited when a new season comes out. And, you know, Daisy came up. It was like 3 a.m. when she came up with this. When she posted this video, she was doing a live, and I was listening to what she was saying, and she said that some of these dumb fucks that target me, what they actually do is, like, they go and they go to a graveyard and do graveyard rituals, which to me, I like graveyards. Like I said, I love getting scared, so back in my day, I used to love hanging around in graveyards, just hoping to see a ghost. So what these people actually do is, like, they go and take graveyard dirt, and then, like, you know, do a ritual. I don't know, these people think they've got a spell for everything. And so the spirits, like, of the dead person, that, like, is, like, in their home, like, they've brought, like, that spirit back into, like, their house, and, like, you know, chaos breaks out and then chaos breaks out in their houses, stuff like that. So yeah, like, hell yeah, I do believe in the supernatural and paranormal. I have a lot of supernatural and paranormal experiences daily, so that's why I do believe in that now. Okay, so as far as I know, there are no laws against black magic or death magic, or any kind of, like, magic for that matter. But I think there should be. I think there should be extremely harsh consequences too. Why? Okay, well, no one says it better than Zach Bagans himself when he says, there are things in this world that we will never fully understand. That is so true. So these people actually don't even know what the fuck. These people don't actually know what they are messing with. At all. They did a death ritual, from what I heard, and it backfired and killed 2 people that were actually involved in that ritual. not their target. That's murder in cold blood. Isn't it? That's how I see it, actually. So, I can't believe that I forgot about this until like the other month when I was, you know, talking about the experience that I had with my cousin when we screwed around with a Ouija board. Look, we're emos. Well, we're emos. Always have been emos. Always will be emos. And at that time, like in our lives, we were both really, really depressed teenagers. And, you know, we organized to go to a music festival together. Ooh, in Toowoomba, where we grew up. And, man. So, you know, when my mom dropped me off at her, because her mom was working, my aunt was working. I know, Natalie, you told me not to tell anyone, but this is for educational purposes, all right? We read stories online about, like, you know, what can happen, you know, using a Ouija board. And she even looked up, like, what the butterfly effect was. So I know what the butterfly effect is, like the movie, because I think I watched the movie before I knew what the butterfly effect was. So, yeah. And, like, we already had read all these horror stories on the internet about what can happen during, like, you know, what can happen, like, you know, when you do a seance and, like, afterwards. All right? So, and you just had, only her and I are actually going to really know, like, you know, what happened that afternoon, but just take my word for it. We were scared shitless, and we didn't know what the fuck we were doing. We were just two emo teenagers. We had no experience, nothing. But, you know, this little boy that the Exorcist movie is based, I'm gonna look this up so I can actually, like, you know, put a name to the face. Okay, so it is, all I found on Google was, yet few realize that the movie and Peter Blatty's novel of the same name are based on a true story. A months-long exorcism by Jesuit priests of a 14-year-old Maryland boy assigned the pseudonym Roland Doe in 1949. Okay, so Roland Doe, that's what his pseudonym is. So yeah, this is a novel. Well, if I find the Ghost Adventures episode, I'll post a link in the description down below. They've got, like, all the info. They do thorough research before they do an investigation. They interview people and stuff. So they're, like, you know, like I said, very, very thorough. So, like, you know, this boy had screwed around with a Ouija board at college, and he had called upon something dark. So he had brought a dark force into the world, and then took it home with him, and then it possessed him, and yeah, he died. How sad is that? I mean, like, fuck, my cousin and I could have died as well. I don't think what we called upon, like, whatever we encountered that day, it was nothing. But we were still so scared. I'm never, ever, ever gonna forget that. We were just so scared. And we were paranoid as hell. Because, like, a very, like, weird, like, really weird things were happening to us. So eventually, like, she called me and she asked me to go. And we just, like, we just burnt everything. But the thing is, okay, we went into, well, he's not like my aunt's actual like husband. I don't think they are married. I don't think they ever got married. But anyway, so my aunt's partner had a shed with like all his tools and bullshit. And, you know, we got like a tiny bit of petrol and we put everything in like this thing. And like we put the tiniest bit of petrol, because we made our own Ouija board like out of paper, just out of an A4 sheet of paper. We used a guitar pick as the pointer and all the other fucking paraphernalia that we, like, you know, had on our altar. And so it just went like thick black smoke. And the fire got like pretty out of control as well. I'm never, ever, ever, ever gonna forget that. But I think most people, you know, that are just curious to know, like, you know, what can happen during a seance, I think they just mess around with it for shits and giggles. But I actually don't think that it should be messed around with. I mean, like, you know, when you're a teenager, you think you're invincible when you're a teenager. And I think that's, you know, what most teenagers do. They, you know, mess around with things that they shouldn't be doing because they think it's cool. yeah, I definitely am not going to do that ever again. I think that, you know, Ouija boards, black magic, death magic should all, like, be completely illegal. Illegal. When you are fucking around with dark shit and bringing dark forces into the world, I think there should be like harsh penalties. You know, people can die from it as well, obviously, from what I've heard. It should be a life sentence. You know, we're trying to, you know, heal the world and make it a better place, as Michael Jackson requested. Heal the world. Make it a better... Don't ask me to sing. The birds and bats will die. So there really is a need to be bringing, like, you know, dark forces into the earth. Yeah, it's... Like, why would you? Why would you want to do that? I don't know why. You know, because it was a rainy day today, I was in bed and I just wanted to watch telly. And I watched this movie with Harry Styles in it. I love Green Eyes. And it's a World War II movie about young, very, very young men, as well as, like, you know, mature, like, you know, men in their 20s and 30s, but also, like, young men that are fighting in, you know, the Second World War. And, you know, there's people dying around them. It was so sad. And you're like, fuck. You know, that actually didn't need to happen. It did not need to happen whatsoever. So, you know, that's just why I just think, like, you know, the world has gone through enough turmoil and tragedy as it is. So there isn't really a need to bring, like, you know, supernatural dark forces into the world. There's no need for it. At all. And because, like, you know, these people, these karmics that I deal with, that are calling upon, like, you know, dark, dark forces, they actually don't even know, like, you know, what they're doing. So because they don't actually know what they're doing, they don't even know how to get rid of whatever they've called upon. By the way, Dunkirk is a awesome movie. It's got a great cast in it too. It's got Tom Hardy in it. I'm quite fond of him. I loved him in the Revenant. And it had, I don't know how to pronounce his name properly because it's Irish. Is it Killian or Cillian Murphy? One of my all-time favorite movies is this movie called Breakfast on Pluto. I love it. I wish that was, like, on Netflix or Stan, but it's not. But it's one of those, like, art house films. It's awesome. It was in the cult section at the video store. Back when we had, you know, videos and DVDs, like, you know, when we had those stores where you could go, like, you know, rent a movie from. So this is from the 6th of August. Professional High Priestess Daisy made this video that these people, so-called people, they are tying themselves to demons to try and defeat you, but they can't pay the piper. I don't even want to know what that's about. Like, me and the darkness and I, like, don't mix. Beg your pardon. At all. Now, I can't remember if this was before or after, you know, Daisy recommended to go and find an anti-satanic practitioner because of, like, you know, the death magic that these people had put on me with, and apparently one of the ingredients in this death, in this ritual, was an actual, like, human sacrifice. I was so shocked. I had no idea what to do. I know that, I only know this from watching Hocus Pocus. When they said that, you know, salt can actually protect you from, like, you know, witches and zombies and stuff. So I thought to myself, okay, well, I know that the ocean is, like, the ocean water is really salty. So I was thinking, like, maybe if I go have a dip in the ocean, because I live, like, close to the beach, that would be enough. But I couldn't fit into my bathing suit, so I didn't go. You know, I know there's a nude beach. What's it called? My brother calls it Digby. Yeah. There were nudists there. I know, because I've in there and I saw nudists. So I can't remember if this was before or after, but anyway, you know, I was just, like, in the dream state and I was having a bath and Daisy came in and she lectured me. She was like, I can tell you haven't been doing your mirror meditations and stuff. And she just scrubbed me in the bath. And she just, like, you know, scrubbed all this magic that was put on me. And when I looked, like, in the bath water, it was really dirty. It wasn't, like, you know, thick, like, muck. It was just, like, you know, just dirty water. She saw my boobs and my, I call it Susie. She saw my Susie. She didn't care though. She was just like, you know, scrubbing all the human sacrifice fucking shit off me. So that was on a Thursday night. It was my mother's birthday that she gave me this bath. Well, I gave myself a bath. She just, like, you know, came and scrubbed all the shit that was on me off. And, like, you know, so that was my mother's birthday on the 12th, which was when I had that. Then on the 13th or 14th, she lives in America though, she came out with this public health report about, you know, black, dark magic effects. She did a lot of research into this, so let's have another listen, shall we? I know that this is already in another video that I made about magic, so let's just have another listen. Just putting it out there, because she's done a lot of research into, you know, dark magic and stuff, like, and she's spreading awareness about dark magic and the effects that it has on the public. This actually deserves a very, very, like, you know, special recognition award or something.
Most public health. So with this series, you're going to be able to learn about the public health impacts of everyday spiritual components, the occult, as well as esotericism. So I really hope you enjoy this series. So for our first episode of the Public Health Report, we are going to be talking about dark magic and its impacts upon the public and our health.
I love how, like, she can be, because she's, like, you know, really smart and educated. How she's like, you know, really smart and professional, but at the same time, like, when she goes off, it's like, anyway.
Now, some of you guys may not think that there's any impact of, you know, spell work or dark magic, and it doesn't have a ripple effect on the public at large, but it definitely does. And we're going to talk about how. First, on the individual level, it amplifies generational trauma. And basically what generational trauma is, it's trauma passed down from one generation to another, which is lodged within the 12-strand DNA of the individual, as well as their lineage. When you're playing with spell work or dark magic, what happens is you're conjuring entities that usually come from a nefarious force or from a force that is very low vibrational and traumatic in nature. So when you're conjuring onto this individual, you're amplifying more of that depending on their own specific frequency, their bloodline, and how they take care of themselves or lack thereof in the present. Now, what's the problem with this generational trauma? Is when you're conjuring onto people, they may have children, right? They may live in an area where other people are picking up the magic, right? And you're amplifying that generational trauma by bringing in those entities that are creating whatever outcome that you want to have, whether it's conflict, whether it's financial strain, whether it's illness, okay? Now, on another hand, there's a lot of trauma that's in the land as well as in the water, because of various historical insults such as colonialism, the transatlantic slave trade, colonization in America and the moving and pushing out of indigenous people from their land across the world. There's a lot of trauma in the land. There's a lot of trauma in the water. When you conjure these entities, the trauma that is still there is being amplified, and it's also being awakened in some ways. The angry spirits, the lost spirits, the sorrowful spirits. So when you're conjuring, not only are you conjuring onto that individual, you're bringing down the entity from whatever planet or system that you're working with, whether it be Saturn or Mars or Pluto. And then on top of that, you're amplifying the trauma that's in the land that's already there. So now we're at a double disadvantage, because not only are we having to clean up the energy from the entity that you pulled down, we're also having to clean up the energy from the ancestors that were disturbed and who have not been able to get their rest, who are now able to feed off of a specific energy for unsolved business, is what I call it. And that unsolved business really looks like these ancestors who have not been appeased, who are not having a restful sleep, is what we call it, who have not been able to fully transition into the spiritual realm because of the way that they passed, are now able to utilize that energy to take on forms in a physical body of somebody else, right? This is a higher level science. On future episodes, we'll go deeper. But that's really the science of it. Now, another thing too is we're going to talk about resonance frequency. Now, what is resonance frequency? A resonance frequency is basically when you're calling down these specific entities and you're attempting to attack someone. Let's say, for instance, their astrological chart has a specific configuration of elements and planets. What you're actually doing is when the entity can't fully attack that individual, they're going to look for other people, right, that have that same similar resonance. Or depending on how wide of a net you cast, let's say you're trying to catch one individual, you end up catching multiple individuals who have that same resonance frequency as the individual you're attempting to target. Now, what we can call this is a type of friendly fire or misfiring, right, or mistarget, whereas the individual that you're trying to target, they may get some of the hit, but other people who are innocent bystanders, right, they also get hit as well. Now, they don't know why they're being attacked, and let's say, for instance, they don't know anything about spiritual warfare, right, and they're walking around depressed or sad or angry or having issues with their health or their finances because, unbeknownst to them, they are being, there's an entity attachment or there's a spiritual warfare that they are actively engaged in that they have no idea about just because they have that resonance frequency. So you always have to be very careful. Me personally, I don't believe in attacking other individuals. There's ways to live on this planet without the utilization of black magic, okay? Another thing that I also want to talk about as well is there is already a lot of trauma on this planet just because of structural violence. The individuals who are in political position, our current economic system, capitalism, etc., right? So when you're calling down these entities and these frequencies to attack somebody else, what you may not realize, and this is something that I always have to talk about, right, individuals, is what you may not realize is that this energy that you're pulling down is actually amplifying the energy of violence. It's amplifying the energy of oppression. And because we already have so many individuals, right, who are in positions of power, who have access to funds, or who may just be in proximity to people who are vulnerable, because they're already in balance, right? And because they are already in a state where they're easily hijacked by low vibrational forces, these energies that you are opening up and that you're calling down, they are picking up on those energies as well, and it's amplifying whatever toxic or negative behavior they have within them. And I wanted to give an example. Some may agree, some may not agree. You've currently been seeing what's been going on in Cuba and Haiti, as well as South Africa, as well as the issues that we're having with femicide across Latin America. A lot of these places are known for the utilization, not just of dark magic, but indigenous practices as well, okay? So we don't want to create any stigma. Unfortunately, these are also the places where a lot of people are hired, right, from individuals who are in the Americas and Britain and things like that, to practice and attack, practice dark magic and attack unsuspecting individuals. So now think about this. We know that these are places where a lot of these practices are being actively done. And now then we turn around and we see within the news that these places are having a whole bunch of riots and things like that overnight. We have to be careful, okay? Because these energies that we are pulling down, they're very volatile. That's the whole entire point of dark magic. You're pulling down on volatile forces to disrupt the life of somebody else. But what you don't realize is, like, again, like I said, other individuals, like we talked about resonance frequency, either they're going to be attacked or they're picking up on the vibration of the anger, right, of the entity, the anger or anguish or whatnot of the entity, warfare, war magic, right? And then they're going out and creating these different type of enactments that then harm the public at large, you see? So you clearly can see how the utilization of dark magic translates from the micro level, which is the smallest part, the individual, to the macro level, which is the community and the public at large. In ancient, and there's something called the Buddhist Tantras. So in ancient India, there was a lot of warfare being waged. And there was something that we have called Buddhist Tantras. And these are basically Buddhists who believe in the use of Tantra, which is a type of sexual magic or sexual energy work. And these Buddhist Tantras, they believe in nonviolence. But they were being attacked so much that they started to have to learn defensive forms of magic and war sorcery. And there's a really good book that I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to leave in the description box, which talks about the different types of war sorcery across various cultures. But these Buddhist Tantras, they started to do something called defensive types of magic, defensive types of war sorcery, whereas nothing would be disturbed, you see. So again, it goes into this point that we made at the very beginning. There's no point to be attacking individuals or conjuring dark entities from different solar systems or different planetary bodies, because they create volatility here on this planet. And as it is, this planet as itself, it's a beautiful planet. And we're here and we're living on it and it feeds us. But unfortunately, because of all the structural violence and environmental degradation, there's more concrete jungles, right? And metal, concrete, and steel fixtures than there is nature, okay? And because we continue to lower the vibration of this planet by tearing down natural sites, by building over sacred sites, okay? As well as destroying the animals and the ecosystems, as well as the ocean, and then filling the planet with man-made materials like plastic and nuclear weapons and things like that. And all those two factors concurrently are lowering the vibration of the planet and activating these entities even more, giving them more power. Okay, so just be careful and watch what you do, because while you think you may be attacking an individual, you're actually impacting the health of the public. So there's going to be a whole lot more discussions that we have on these various topics and how they translate to the public at large. I hope you guys enjoyed this first episode, okay? Thank you so much for watching. Once again, my name is Arjuna Daisy, and I hope you enjoy the public health report. Bye!
Now, do you know what this reminded me of? When she said, when people are targeting, like, one person with black magic or dark magic or whatever, how it can, like, it can, like, mistarget and affect someone else, an innocent bystander. Now, I remember that there were bitches that were, well, even Andrea Smelly Box said that there were, like, that ugly fat toad, and, his coven of bitches, coven of witches that, he's associated with were doing, like, spells on me to, like, make me overeat and make me gain weight. For one, I don't think that actually affected me because, like, I've got polycystic ovary syndrome. I have struggled with weight my entire life. I can eat air and gain weight. And because I was eating a lot of junk and I was drinking Coca-Cola, like, every single day, it's no wonder why I gained a lot of weight really fast. Now, I've been working out and I've actually lost weight just as fast. So I don't think that actually affected me. But Daisy shared a video of this 10-year-old girl in Africa that is morbidly obese. Her family took her to a medical center in the city, like wherever they live, and they found nothing wrong with her whatsoever. And her brother, who was a little, like, older than her, died of the exact same condition because there was, like, you know, so much fat in their veins that, you know, clogged all their, like, clogged, like, you know, his heart and his arteries and his heart, and he died. So I know that a lot of, like, women that attack me, that fuck around with spell work, they are of African, like, you know, descent, or they are, like, you know, African. They're like either like full African or like partially African. That could have been, like, you know, one of their relatives or someone from the same bloodline that they actually ended up affecting. Because even that girl's mother said, we actually do believe that this is witchcraft or a curse. So see how it does affect every single one of us when there's no need for it. So I hope you bitches are pleased with yourselves. And I hope that you're pleased and happy with yourselves, knowing that people, like, have died from all the lies and bullshit that you've spread about me. What to fucking lie and say that I had a miscarriage or I aborted, like, Luke's baby when I've never met the cunt. Well done. I hope you're proud of yourselves. I wonder why that's why Lulu was like, slow down the investigation. Slow down the investigation. Have you ever seen that movie, that episode of Breaking Bad? Where Jesse gets, like, you know, one of those meth heads to, like, dig in the front lawn with a shovel. She was, like, that frantic. Like, slow down the investigation. Slow down the investigation. And then, like, you know, choking and shit on all these, like, black fumes that were coming out of, like, this pot. Ugh. Gross. Anyway, she is correct when she says, like, you know, this is actually a beautiful planet. It's a beautiful world. It feeds us. There is no need for this shit. Absolutely. Now, when she was saying about, like, there is a lot of trauma in the land already. You'll have to see it to believe it. I think I did watch this on YouTube, actually. It was the episode of Ghost Adventures, the Sharon Tate episode. You know that Charles Manson dick. All right, he's a coward. He's a Luke. Luke is a Charles Manson. Because, like, you know, Charles Manson didn't actually murder anyone. He, you know, got other people to do his dirty work for him. Because he's a coward and had, like, no cock or balls. I don't like cowards. I don't like cowards. So Ghost Adventures, like, you know, investigated, you know, Sharon Tate's home, and they actually felt like they actually captured an apparition that actually looked like a pregnant woman, and she was 8 months pregnant when the Manson family murdered her. Now, when they were doing their research, they found that her home was actually built on an ancient Indian burial ground, or a sacred Indian burial ground. So, yeah, it was a lot of, like, you know, paranormal stuff that went on in their investigation. And they say that, you know, when you pass, like, you know, that ghosts are unrested souls that have unfinished business. They haven't, you know, they're still lingering around. They don't even know that they're dead. Or they probably do, but they just, like, haven't crossed over yet. So if they've died, you know, quite violently, then just imagine what conjuring up demons, especially like if they've been, I just can't get the temperature in the room like quite right. It's either too cold with the fan on or it's too hot without the fan on. I hate summer. I think it's also my hormones too. Woo! You know, people that have been, that like people that died very violent deaths, they're still like, their spirit is still here and they're really angry. So if they, these people like, you know, call upon a dark force and then like it angers a spirit, like, yeah. Yeah, I understand, like, you know, what Daisy means. But yeah, like I said, there are no laws against black magic, dark magic, you know, death magic, what have you. But there should be. And this is exactly why. I know there are some people out there that are skeptics. That's fine too. That's okay. If you don't believe, you don't believe. You know, what I did find out, well, there is this guy that I listened to on YouTube. His name is, I don't know what his actual name is, but his channel is called Scorpio Only Tarot. Sorry, I didn't hear. And he said, I was listening to him a few days, he was saying that there was like a group of people that were caught doing death spells on me, that they were like, you know, doing, like, you know, speaking death on my videos and on my photos, like, you know, hoping that's going to kill me. Apparently they were caught doing that. Like, spells are energy. Look, even makeup is spells, because like, well, with me, I'm ugly with or without makeup. It's just fun. I love how the eyeshadow looks in the light. But, because like, makeup only enhances beauty. It doesn't actually show you what the person actually looks like. So that's a spell. It's an illusion. It's energy. Excuse me. Excuse me. So, you know, as I said, oh yeah, Scorpio's Only Tarot. Yeah, like, I don't know his name. Scorpio's Only Dude. I was listening to him on Christmas because, fuck. If only you knew how hot this apartment gets in summer. I just could not sleep. It's like I'm living in a microwave. So anyway, I couldn't sleep the other night. And he was saying that these dumb fucks are like, you know, the crooked law enforcement that, you know, these people are trying to get me set up and framed and whatever, are also like, you know, using death spells on me. And then they're going to lie in court. They're planning to lie in court about it. Oh, that's right. They wanted to have me incarcerated to get money. Fuck off. Okay, so, oh yeah. I also heard another rumor that these couch potatoes... Well, Daisy said that these people were like, you know, saying that all of this happened because it was a money spell gone wrong. No, don't think so. Or that I, oh, beg your pardon. Or that I did a money spell that went wrong. No. Okay, so there is a video that I did about manifesting or manifestations stuff. There was a meditation that I found on YouTube years ago, when I was saving up when I was working and saving up to go on a pilgrimage overseas. It is extremely powerful. Extremely powerful. And you don't have to do anything. You don't have to lift a finger. All you have to do is just get, like, you know, just lay somewhere comfortable. Make sure you're not driving or anything. Just make sure that you're laying down in a very comfortable space. And you meditate with that guy that's, like, you know, that's instructing you, like, you know, what to do. It worked for me every single time. So, like, you know, it was 3 a.m. I hadn't made any money at work. And so I said to the receptionist, I was like, fuck, may I go upstairs to one of the rooms that was vacant? Because I said I was going to go and smoke a joint. But I was actually wanting to do this meditation to manifest, like, you know, some money, to make some money for that evening. And so I said that I wanted to make, like, you know, $300 that night. I walked out with $360. When I wanted to stop working already and just go on this trip, I said, you know, I was doing my meditation, you know, I wanted to earn $10,000. And what happened? I had a very lovely customer. It was his birthday. He was lonely. And so he had me for 3 hours. And we just sat in the spa and we just chilled out, had some champs. And he asked me, like, you know, what am I doing in a place like this? And I said, I'm just, like, you know, working to save up to go traveling. And he looked on the website and saw that I was on the roster until, like, you know, Sunday. So he came in on my last day and he saw me for an hour and he gave me an envelope that had $10,000 cash in it. So I had that plus all the money that I earned. So there's really no need to, like, you know, do spells and shit when that's a very, very powerful manifestation. Meditation! You know, when people, you know, do talk about manifesting and they don't have anything to show for, it's also a lot to do with karma. If you're a C word, God, the Most High, is not going to want you to have a damn thing. But, you know, as they say, do good and it'll come back to you in unexpected ways. Like, all your good come will come back to you in unexpected ways. That's so true as well. I've also heard some that really hurt my throat when I yelled. It's really like, it hurts. Every time I scream or yell, it hurts. And it starts cranking out. I've heard necromancy a lot this year. I'm going to look it up. What it means. I know what necrophilia is. Okay, so shut up. Let me explain. All right. So You're never gonna look at me the same. But when I was in grade 12, we had to do this unit, which was called Shock and the New. So, and I was at a Catholic school as well. So we had to come up with, like, you know, something original that was going to shock everyone. And so I have absolutely no idea. This wasn't my idea, just FYI. And I was talking to one of my friends. We're not friends anymore though. And, you know, I said, what should I do for my art project? Because the unit is called Shock and the New. And he said, make it necrophilia. And the silence of being inside someone for the very last time. I'm not going to tell you what I did, but it wasn't an actual dead person, but it was something sick. I got in so much trouble. I almost got suspended as well. So I had to like redo it. And so I asked my boyfriend who I was dating then to shave his pubes. And it was a dildo that was coming out of this canvas. And so, like, the words read, which were just made out of glue and my boyfriend's pubes, my mother told me. Well, they said, you know, shocking. So I shocked them, all right. Ooh, okay. So necromancy is the supposed practice of communicating with the dead, especially in order to predict the future. Yeah, I talk to dead people all the time. But I can't help it. Like, it's in the dream state too, like it's in the astral realm. I've had many encounters with Peter Steele. We've had relations in the astral realm. Yeah. And he's given me like a lot of like warning messages and like, you know, told me like, you know, what's going on behind my back that I don't see because people are fucking sneaky and underhanded. So, yeah. I don't think that's anything bad. Unless it's something evil, unless they're trying to communicate with like something like really evil, then yeah, I think that should be made illegal. It is so hot in here. It's so hot in here. So basically, like, you know, this is just why I think that there should be laws against, death magic and dark magic. And like I said, like, I watched Dunkirk today. I burst out crying in a particular scene. I don't want to talk about it because, like, you know, it is sad. You know, this world has been through a lot of tragedy as it is. So we actually don't need to be like, you know, making it even worse with calling upon like, you know, supernatural dark forces. We're supposed to be living in heaven on earth instead of like living in hell on earth. So yeah, hopefully this will come into effect in the near future. As for these dumb fuck law enforcements that are trying to like, you know, set me up or get me framed, getting those fucking, oh my god, these bitches that stalk me and follow me, you can actually tell if someone is a piece of shit just by looking at them, because they actually do look like an ugly old witch. They just have like those noses, those crooked noses, and they've got like, you know, very, very like thin lips. To stalk me just so you can like, you know, plant shit into my apartment, make fake emails trying to like, you know, frame me and set me up. Eat shit, and eat shit. get fucked and leave me alone. No, I'm not going to prison, you cunts are, and getting terminated from your jobs. Oh my god, there is a movie with Chris Evans called Knives Out, and he tells his whole family to eat shit. He's like, eat shit, eat shit, eat shit, especially eat shit. It's so funny in his Boston accent. So yeah, eat shit. So, yeah, it's been a very, very difficult year to get through. It's been a tough year to get through. Like, just being attacked behind my back constantly. People stalking you constantly. Constantly plotting on you when you're just enjoying your life and loving your job. Disgusting. Absolute filth. I mean, like, I wouldn't spread someone's picture. If I was fucking someone that I really liked, I wouldn't spread naked pictures of them on the internet. That is fucked up. That's also called revenge porn, and yeah, you can go to prison for that. Just saying. So no, one of the pictures that Luke was spreading around was by a client, an ex-client of mine called Isaac, and he ran an IT company. Well, he told me his name was Isaac anyway. I don't know what the fuck his real name was. But I still have your number. And I still like know where you work. So yeah, I don't know, I just don't like criminals that like, you know, spreading nude pictures of me everywhere to like maintain a very disgusting lie and to like hide bodies and whatever the fuck else. It's sick. It is beyond sick. You're a sick bastard. Oh yeah, also, you know, Daisy also said that, like, you know, some of the fucks that I deal with, like, they fuck around with dark magic while they're being, like, while they are pregnant, or, like, you know, when they have a baby in their lap, and that child is actually going to come out reprobate, so they're actually going to end up giving birth to a demon. So they're actually, like, you know, birthing real demons out of their vaginas. Well, good luck dealing with that. Especially when it's going through puberty. Fuck. So why the fuck would anyone actually want to bring a dark force into the world? Makes no sense to me. But yeah, this is why I think Ouija boards should be made illegal and evil, you know, dark magic, death magic shit should be made illegal too. There should be like laws against it and very like harsh consequences. Oof. I just finished watching The Tudors last night. I'm probably gonna watch it again. I was really into Tudor history in grade 11. I loved it. What, like, I think it was like the last few episodes, they racked a woman that was accused of heresy. Do you know what they, like, you know, the stretching racks? And they stretched her to the point where the strings in her legs and arms were perished. And they carted her to burn her at the stake for heresy. Then that priest that, you know, tortured her and, you know, sentenced her to death was actually found of stealing money from the king. I know, it's crazy, right? It is crazy. In my books, that's pure evil. That is pure evil. She wasn't doing anything. That scared me. She wasn't doing anything like bad at all. But imagine living in those days. I mean, like, fuck. The Salem witch trials, when they actually burnt witches at the stake. They accused innocent women of witchcraft and burnt them at the stake. So yeah, it's probably a good thing. Probably a good thing that we aren't living in the Dark Ages anymore. Because you would be burnt alive and skinned alive. Yeah, I hope everyone just gets the point of this message. It's hot as hell in here. To be honest, I'm just drained completely. I'm also under the weather. I'm on antibiotics again. I'm just fucked. It has just been such a tough year to get through. Like I said, having disgusting, yeah. I deserve to call you fucks this. Cunts. Just constantly at me all year. Just fuck off. You're disgusting. You're jealous. And you're greedy. And what you deserve is a good kick up the ass. And you're lucky that I do give a fuck about my own Akashic record. Because if you fucked with anyone else, you'd be in your graves. So yeah, oh yeah, Scorpio's only dude said that you were fucking around with witchcraft and stuff. Like, on my photos, like, you know, hoping, like, you know, putting suicide and depression and anxiety, like, spelled on me, on my videos, on my photos. But didn't you accuse me of running a coven of witches? With what evidence and what proof? Or running an international crime ring. That's fucked up. That's actually going to go into your Akashic records too. So not only are you not going to get the money that you were hoping to steal from me, you're going to be paying me out for all that fucking stress and anxiety that you put me through. And you're also going to be apologizing to me publicly. Disgusting. But yet no one actually came to my door at all and asked me any questions, did they? No. You were talking lies about me behind my back, not to my face. That is a cunt act. That is coward shit. So anyway, yeah. I can't believe it's already the end of the year. This is, like, the year has actually gone by so slow for me because of this shit. But, you know, I didn't let it get the best of me. So, yeah. You just have to, you know, that's why it's important to, like, just build a connection with God. You know. I mean, like, every time you get, like, every time you go through something rough, that's always a opportunity right there to build your connection with the Most High. So, yeah. So, I'm going to get out of here. Enjoy what's left of the year. Oh, no, I might be back tomorrow. I don't know. Like I said, I need some, because that tower is going to hit soon. That tower is going to hit soon. Scorpios only said that there are people going to be reaching out to me with a whole heap of info about, like, what's been going on behind my back. Not in front of my, like, not under my nose. So, fuck. Yeah. You are just all, just admit it, you're jealous, you're envious, and you're fucking crazy. So, yeah, I'm gonna go to bed. Well, I might play The Sims, I don't know. Don't know. Because my computer is tapped, it slows down the game, which is annoying. But until next time, I love you. Stay safe. Stay healthy. And I love you. To the rest of you motherfuckers, oh, I don't care. Just fuck off.